everybody. We're here apparently at the same time as an ICP concert, which is pretty cool because they're cool with us too, and you know, all that happy fun stuff. And they're wearing almost as much makeup as we are. But we're gonna march downtown Tucson tonight, and I'm bringing my puppy with me. All cute looking, like Audrey Hepburn and everything, and it's just a great time to be alive and celebrating, you know, things like the victory of the death of Don't Ask, Don't Tell, finally, and everything that's gonna be coming soon, and you know, it's just a great time to be alive, and it's a great time to be proud.
Outwest, all the viewers, happy Pride. Glad to be here.
I'm not high. I'm just saying high. still coming up. We're here at Pride in the Desert. I saw Jennifer Cornet backstage. We met Dario earlier this afternoon. And we're going to keep you rocking tonight, guys. Enjoy Pride in the Desert. We got a little bit of time left with you.
Hi, guys. Everyone say hello to OutWest TV, please.
Hello, OutWest TV.
Look at all that artery clogging fat, man.
And the stuff on the grill isn't that great either.
I know. It's already clogged my arteries.
Hug him, hug your damn banana. Hug your banana.
Lay down inside. Woman, you need love.
This year?
It's very different. Very different than the past few years.
Thank you. What do you folks think about Pride this year?
It's good. Good. Pretty good. We like it here.
Great.
Yeah, thank you.
What do you think about Pride this year? You enjoy it?
I like coming to a baseball game. It's fun.
Cool. Great.
In Tucson.
Yeah. What's so great about being gay?
Being gay.
It's being who you are.
Sounds good to me.
Being who you are, yeah.
Thank you. And being on TV?
And being on TV.
Yay!
Cool.
My name's Ernie. I'm with OutWest TV. And I have to have you ask, answer me one question. What's so great about being gay?
I get to do this shit, bitch. Of course.
What's so great about being gay?
So great about being gay. Everything. Dressing up.
There you go.
Looking for shopping. How about that? Shopping.
You look gorgeous. You look beautiful.
I'm going to come up with
it. That's it. And I want to ask you a question. You're willing to answer? What's so great about being gay?
Everything. Yes.
Everything.
Say hello to OutWest TV. So are you liking the new Pride Festival?
It's my first one.
Ah.
Yes.
Are you enjoying it? Are you enjoying it?
Oh, man. Yes, I am.
Yay. Thank you.
Go through their lives, lost in confusion.
Everybody see. Come on. Some people worry too much, while others are thinking. Yeah. But you got to remember one thing. It's not your life they're living. No, no. What if you got to lose by being honest with yourself? Everybody say,
this is me.
Everybody
say,
uh-huh.
You
time than the one my brother knew. A time when those infected with HIV enter a hospital and they are treated with the same respect and dignity as every other patient. A time when a cocktail of medications can keep those with HIV alive longer and healthier than ever before. A time when a cure for AIDS is on the horizon. I can only hope that my daughter Anna will someday live in that time, when there is a cure, when there are no new infections. A time when she can tell her children of her Uncle Louie, of a disease that called AIDS that took his life but could never take their lives. Until that time, I hope we all can keep supporting organizations like SAFE so they can continue their invaluable work, providing essential services to those with HIV, conducting outreach and prevention programs, and bringing awareness and education to our youth like my daughter Anna. I would now like to introduce my daughter, who has been participating in the AIDS Walk and the opening of the AIDS Quilt since she was 4 years old.
Hi, my name is Anna Jean White, and I've been doing the AIDS Walk for 5 years.
There's no future. There is no past. Thank God this moment's not the last. There's only us. There's only this. Forget, regret, or life is yours to miss. No.
I wanted to share a video that I found from a Canadian television personality by the name of Rick Mercer. He's got a show very much like Jon Stewart's Daily Show. It's usually very funny and satirical, but sometimes he gets pretty serious. And he took on the issue of teenage bullying and teen suicide. And remember, we need to change the name. It's not bullying when someone dies. It's criminal harassment. But watch the video.
Every year in this country, 300 kids take their own lives. It is a mind-boggling number. And this past week, one of those kids was Jamie Hubley. He was 15, he was depressed, and he happened to be gay. And because this is 2011, we just don't read about a kid like Jamie, we can Google him. And then the next thing you know, you're sitting at home watching on YouTube. And he was gay, all right. He was a great big goofy gay kid singing Lady Gaga on the internet. And as an adult, you look at that and you go, you know what? That kid's going places. But for some reason, some kids, they looked at that and they attacked. And now he's gone. And because this story is all too familiar, we know exactly what's going to happen next. Grief counselors will go into the school as they should. But what about the old-fashioned assembly? You know, where the cops show up and there's hell to pay and they find out who's responsible. You know, like when the lunchroom is vandalized. Because the kids who bullied this boy, they know who they are. And more importantly, other kids know who they are. It's no longer good enough for us to tell kids who are different that it's gonna get better. We have to make it better now. That's every single one of us, every teacher, every student, every adult has to step up to the plate. And that's gay adults too, because I know gay cops, soldiers, athletes, cabinet ministers, a lot of us do, but the problem is, adults, we don't need role models. Kids do. So if you're gay and you're in public life, I'm sorry, you don't have to run around with a pride flag and bore the hell out of everyone, but you can't be invisible, not anymore. 300 kids is 300 too many.
I'm talking today with T.C. Tolbert, who has a great project that he's been working on for the last few years. T.C., thank you for letting me into your home and into your workspace. Tell us a little bit about the kite project. What is the website called?
Yeah, it's Made for Flight, and so you can find out more information at madeforflight.com. And it's a commemorative project for youth, specifically to build allies to the transgender community. I'm transgender, and basically, I started the project a couple of years ago because I was going to Transgender Day of Remembrance, which is on November 20th every year, and it was always just this small gathering of trans people.
Yes, and it was the same people.
Exactly,
all the time.
You know, yeah. and it felt, obviously we're commemorating trans people who've been murdered, so it was really heavy and sad event, but there was something about it just being trans people who were coming to the event that made it feel exceptionally lonely, because it felt like, are we the only ones who know or who care, because it happens to be our community. And so I just really wanted to engage allies and bring folks in, you know, to raise awareness and also to know that other people had our back, you know? And
okay.
So that was how I sort of landed on creating a project that engaged youth who may not identify as gay or lesbian or transgender and just want to be allies.
Okay.
So that's what it's for.
The kites, what is the symbolism behind the kites?
Yeah, good question. So, like I was talking about at those Transgender Day of Remembrances that I was going to, where it was just, 10 trans people holding hands and feeling really sad.
Uh-huh.
I'd noticed for myself, I was looking down a lot, and feeling ashamed and looking down and really focusing on the fact that the people we were commemorating, I was focusing on the horrific way that they died. And I was thinking about two things. One, how could we shift the focus instead of shame and fear to a celebration of these people's lives? Certainly we have to acknowledge and honor the fact that they were murdered in really mm-hmm. horrible ways, but also to remember that they lived as well, and that we're alive, you know, as trans people who are coming together, and that we have really beautiful lives too. So it's just trying to come up with, you know, with something that people could get involved in, but that would also have that symbolism of sort of raising our attention and feeling really beautiful and resilient. And honestly, just, I don't know, the kite, you know.
I mean, the kite is, yeah.
Seems to work really well for that.
It does, yeah, yeah. So. And okay, you were talking about the trans monitoring, wow.
Yeah, the Trans Murder Monitoring Project out of Transgender Europe. And what they've done is for the last 5 years, they've compiled statistics in terms of where people have been murdered, how they were murdered, their ages, you know, as much information, as much demographic information as they can find on each murder globally. And so we have an organization in the United States called the National Center for Transgender Equality, so NCTE. And they put out a report earlier this year that estimated in the U.S. a transgender person is murdered once a month. And globally, the Trans Murder Monitoring Project reports that a transgender person is murdered every other day in the world. And so, but just like you said, I mean, it's underreported, and you know, for a lot of these folks, you'll look and see a lot of the kites say unknown name, or we don't have even last names or, you know, information about them. And I think that's a direct result of transphobia and folks worldwide not knowing how to interact with, how to be respectful of trans people.
Yeah. But obviously the trans community is getting more public allies. Mm-hmm. Chaz Bono, of course,
right.
Is the most noted.
Most recent.
Yeah, most recent. I was very surprised to see on certain television shows that there are more and more trans actors and actresses, you know, that play trans people. You know, it's not just a man dressing up as a woman, or, you know. So there's obviously getting a little more acceptance. I think the next... And this is just my personal opinion, the next big obstacle is acceptance in the workplace.
Oh, that's huge.
Yeah,
absolutely.
Are you hoping that through this kind of observance and this kind of visibility that you're going to find more people more accepting of trans people at work?
Everywhere. Yeah, everywhere. Absolutely.
What's the number... that you know of murders this year?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's a great question. According to the Trans Murder Monitoring Project, since January of this year, 116 murders worldwide. And so you can see on some of the kites what we've done, because we don't have names, like I mentioned, for all of them. We know there have been 29 murders in Brazil, and so we made a kite for Brazil.
Okay.
You know, yeah, down there.
Yes.
And then 7 so far in the United States, so we made one. You know, so we've sort of also broken it up in that way to commemorate the folks that, you know, who we don't have names for.
Yes. Wow. And all these will be on display at the All Souls procession on November
6th. Yeah.
November 6th. Will they also be on display afterwards? Where will that be?
Yeah, thanks for asking. They will. So All Souls Procession will be marching together, processing together, and November 14th through the 19th, we have a week-wide Transgender Awareness Week, and so it starts off with a kickoff event, which is at the U of A, and anyone's welcome to that, on the mall, the week poetry reading, and display of the kites during the day, so that's from 11 to 1. But then throughout the week, we have events. You know, you were talking about earlier, you know, wanting to ask trans people questions and, you know, just wanting to get more information. So we're doing things like a Transgender 101 workshop and a panel where you can ask a transgender person anything. You know, so anything you ever wanted to know.
That's
you
a can good come idea. To that panel. Yes.
And then on Thursday night, we have a poetry reading at Flux Gallery at 7. And then on Friday night, we have a big performance, which we're really excited. We're bringing in a trans performer, and his name is D'Lo, and he's going to be doing a It was a fantastic performance piece and keynote speech, which I'm really excited about. And then on Saturday, that's when we're having the Day of Remembrance Candlelight Vigil. And so that's at 5:30 Saturday the 19th. And we start at the U of A main fountain, and then we'll display the kites, but we're also then going to walk down 4th Avenue with the kites so that so that we're really interacting with people who may not know anything about the trans community. And we'll be handing out information and things like that just to connect with folks as much as possible.
So I hope everyone decides to join in and support the Transgender Day of Remembrance and the week of remembrance, and just learn more about the trans community and learn to replace fear with knowledge.
Exactly. Uh-huh. That is the key.
Yes.
Your eyes to me are precious stones on a page that's made of solid gold. When a